additional 8,000 U.S. troops arrived in East Timor today in the biggest... Military intelligence released the information that Darah Dandoa leader Suwadi Sadano was not only responsible, but on site at the March 28th hostage crisis at the U.S. Embassy to East Timor. Headed by Abraham Zerkezi to reverse engineer the programs developed for the Georgian information crisis was declared a success by its UN. Sporadic clashes with Darah Dandoa guerrillas along the East Timor border. No U.S. casualties were...
What do you think?
The world is small, nasty, and complicated, and everybody dies alone.
What do you think about Norman Soth?
He's small, nasty, and complicated. I guess how he'll die is up to him.
I don't think Soth even knows whether or not he's still working for the CIA.
I'm a good judge of character.
That must be why we get along so well.
Hesperia Railways, Paris, Tunis, France, April 2nd, 2006, 21:52 hours. Meet Norman Soth. CIA-trained operative Norman Soth has been looking to earth southbound Hesperia Railways train, accompanied by a squad of French-Syrian mercenaries. Locate and question Soth in order to determine his status as an enemy or friendly operative. Now, I don't know if you guys have been noticing or not, but if you look at the cinematics, there are actually quite a lot of references to chaos theory. I mean, the previous cinematic had a reference to the formation of the ISTF. This cinematic had a reference to, well, Abraham Zerkezi, and his algorithms to, well, basically reverse engineer the Georgian information crisis and that bug. So, yeah, I mean, I guess the Third Echelon should just have been following up on the news a little more closely. But I don't know whether that was a matter of public information anyway, mass occurrence. I don't know how the news got wind of it, but I guess it's public information at this point of time. So as far as Pandora Tomorrow is concerned anyway. But to recapitulate on the story thus far, a terrorist attacked the U.S. Embassy, and in an effort to find out who it is, Sam gets information from Douglas Shetland that it is in fact a group of mercenaries known as the Darah Dandoa, and they are being organized by some man who goes by the username of Mortified Penguin. This Mortified Penguin turns out to be a complete ghost, and the only person who knows about him, he originates his last signal came from a cryogenics lab in Paris, and upon investigation there, it turns out that nobody actually knows who he is, and that there's only one picture of him that one security guard managed to take, and now they're trying to kill him as well. We don't know whether the security guard lives or not, but we got a picture of him, and we still don't know anything. So yeah, we tracked his current whereabouts, and I don't know how we managed to do that, but now we're going to listen into his conversations and try and determine which side of the game he's on. So he was supposed to be a CIA deep cover agent, but we don't know anything about it anymore.
Mutually exclusive.
Hippie. Until we know different, we're treating him as a friendly. So don't blaze cover. Any alarms mean mission over. If Soth sees you before you see him, the mission's over. Don't do anything to compromise him.
Does that include killing him?
Yeah. Leave him alive, if you don't mind. Updates on your OPSAT.
This thing was quite noisy, actually. I don't know how it's gonna, you know, turn out in the final game, but yeah, I would expect a train traveling like hundreds of miles an hour to be this noisy. But one of the reasons that I don't exactly like this level, I mean, this level is charming, it is really charming, but one of the reasons that I really don't like this level all the time is simply, well,
another complication for you. Found the credit cards our man Poindexter, aka Soth, used to buy the train tickets.
What's the complication?
Two seats in coach. Looks like you have at least two terrorists mixed in with the civvies in the cheap seats.
But you're dealing with tight quarters. I wouldn't risk anything lethal. You don't have the room to maneuver if there are complications.
Rush. Yeah, as I was saying, one of the reasons that we do not... I do not like particularly like this game is not this game rather, but just this mission in specific.
What is that?
Hello, conductor? Does anybody know where the lights are?
So I guess that would. Yeah, one of the reasons that I don't specifically like this level is all of the set pieces in this level. I mean, just look at this. And yeah, this is just one of the examples of how this level is completely full of set pieces. And you need to be like really careful about where you're gonna go next, because like for example this person here, he needs to stop looking at you so that you can progress further. Yeah, so you just have to like move ahead a little so that that person would finally stop and get you. And I guess we're clear to go from here or not. Except for that one train. I mean, they really try to make this level very action-oriented from what it looks like.
Brunton's chums in the CIA came through for us.
Soth's right leg has more prosthetics in it than Lee Major's.
Apparently, he had a disagreement with a landmine.
Might register different on thermal.
Perfect.
Monsieur, you requested earplugs?
Ah, yes.
I'm very sorry, but I couldn't find any. If your neighbors start shouting again, please feel free to call me and I'll ask them to be quiet.
Thank you.
I'm very sorry.
So we head into another, you know, set piece right here. As long as this guy has his door open, we can't really move on ahead. Although we could probably like move along the side of the railroad. I do feel like we could do that, but for whatever reason, this guy, well, he needs to close his doors, basically. Either that or... yeah, pretty much so. We can't look in there. That does not seem like normal Soth. I mean, I can see both of his legs, so... yeah, I do not think that's normal Soth. Oops, not what I meant to do. That would be normal Soth. Now, I wonder what we do next. Like, I think we got confirmation that this is indeed normal Soth, because his leg there is sort of asleep. So I wonder what we can do to, you know, like, sort of get to his cave. This room seems empty, so we can probably get into it. Apparently Soth is sleeping, so it's completely okay to open this door. And we can't really hack into his computer or anything.
Wake up, Poindexter.
First, you tell me, who are you?
I'm your Uncle Sam, come to make sure you're still one of the good guys.
How do I trust you?
Your name's Norman Soth. Ask me about the chestnut tree.
Okay, fine. What are you doing here? If the men I'm with catch us talking, they'll kill us both.
To make your Sedona story fast.
It's an agency job. The Joint Chiefs want a military presence in Indonesia, and I was part of the plan. That's all I can say.
Who's your runner?
Clifton Finch.
What about the cryogenics lab?
Sir?
What is it now?
You have a phone call.
Stay hidden and don't make a noise.
Sorry if I woke you. It's him.
Is this a fresh phone?
We put the chip in just an hour ago.
Good, let's go to the bar car. I don't want to talk here.
He was lying about his handler, wasn't he?
Yeah. Finch has been on sick leave for 16 months. Hack the laptop now. And trail Soth. Laser mic that call. We still can't risk blowing Soth's cover. Fisher, we need that phone call. Dime to a dollar, he's talking to Sedona.
It depends on our Mossad leak. I don't know, 80%, maybe 90. I just have a bad feeling about this train. I think our cover's blown. Hold on. No, it's just a feeling I have. I don't think it's safe to talk right now. Okay, but make it fast. I'm glad. Stay worried. Shin, bet. Are you kidding? I could barely believe Mossad, much less. Of course, of course. Always assume they know what you're doing. Exactly. It's a joke. Right. Mein Gott, I can walk. 4 more days, tops, then you're bulletproof. It's not safe to talk now. I need to get off this train. No, no, I can't. It's not possible. Of course. Till next time.
Good work. Grim?
Give me a sec. Focusing on the Timorese Mombe for expediency's sake. The new translator will take a few seconds to catch up.
Take your time.
There. Springfield demonstration. 80% plus fatalities. Custer would be proud. What the hell does that mean?
Nothing good. What about that?
Might be daily phone calls to delay release. Translator's still a little hinky.
Right. We've got enough to work with. Get topside, Fisher. We're pulling you out of there.
Should we clear the road now? Okay, so yeah, this level has a few, well, quite a lot of sort of, you know, moments like these where you really have to be precise with the way you move. And, you know, like, they just want you to do things.
We've got visitors, our cover's been blown. We're getting off the train now.
Talk to me about level of force.
It's them or you.
Very, very, well, actually, let me just read this first. I've been unable to get that thought out ever since the beginning where I've been, you know, trying to say it. I'll just get it out of this. Hesperia Railways, Paris to Nice, France, April 2nd, 2006, 22:40 hours, mission complete. Intelligence gathered from Soth's laptop referenced a potentially lethal Springfield demonstration, a potential terrorist event intended for an American target. Soth was allowed to continue onwards towards Jerusalem. Now, he does talk about Shinbet, and ironically, we do have a Shinbet, you know, operative in the very next stage. No spoilers for you guys, but yeah, basically, yeah, that's hinting at something, that's foreshadowing something. And, while the plot of this game is a little bit more well connected, I feel like, as compared to the first bit itself, I still do not particularly like this level. I mean, the first time, the second time you play this level, it's extremely charming. You feel just like a ninja with all those, you know, elements, the magical elements. But once you keep playing it over and over again, it just gets boring very quickly. And honestly, it's more like a very, very specially designed puzzle with very, very specific solutions. And that's the entire part of this entire, you know, Paris-Nice level that I really dislike, the train level. I would much rather prefer, you know, it being open-ended and us having much many more options, although you cannot have that many options in the train. But I would say that even Chaos Theory, or you know, even in the latter levels of Pandora Tomorrow and Splinter Cell 1, the cyber submarine levels, you've got far less options in the damn submarine, and you've still got like such great stealth gameplay. It's just this level and the way that Ubisoft Shanghai wants the player to play the game, the way they designed it, which they just treat the game far more like a, you know, procedural puzzle game than an actual stealth game. And it just, yeah, it's heavily scripted. It's very heavily scripted, and you just, well, have to do things at their terms. If you try to, you know, change things up, do things in a different manner, it doesn't really suit them. And sometimes, like the blooper I showed you guys in the last video from Cryogenics, Sonya Cryogenics, they just sometimes go out of their way to make sure that, you know, you are following their exact solution, their exact program solution, like the phone ringing just because we were standing in front of it. That is something that feels trollish and not something that I would appreciate from a stealth game. So, yeah, but that's just me, of course. I mean, there are people who love the hell out of Pandora Tomorrow, and especially this level, just because it is so linear and heavily scripted. So yeah, to each their own. But yeah, I personally particularly do not really like this level that much. Moving on, we basically got some information from Soth's laptop. Soth was actually, you know, he had actually turned, unlike Fisher with the JPA, Soth does actually turn over to the Darah Dandoa, and yeah, he is working for them. He is looking to make you know, participate in what is known as the Springfield demonstration, which we the data for which we obtained after hacking his laptop. And yeah, basically we talk to him in hopes of finding some information, but we honestly could not really find it. We did not take him out because we did not want them to think that the plan was compromised, in hopes of, you know, catching them red-handed. But as it turns out, we're not the only intelligence agency in the world. So yeah, I'll just leave it at that. We'll elaborate on that in the next video, whenever that might be. I don't know when that is, since I'm recording both Daggerfall and Pandora Tomorrow at the same time. And I do not think I've said an intro this time around. I do not think so, no. But at any rate, yeah, thank you for tuning in, thank you for watching, thank you for sticking around. This has been Tom Clancy's Let Us Help Pandora Tomorrow, and in our next video, we will be covering the Jerusalem mission, which is, again, it's a personal favorite of mine. I actually like the Jerusalem mission. It's very open-ended in a sort of way. Even though it's not, but it's really quite charming and adventurous though. So, yeah, I'll see you guys then. Until then, take care. Farewell, fellow Earthlings.